Blog Talk Radio.
I just want to, like, take a salt bath and go take a nap. I've been just going nonstop all day, and it's my body's like, no more. It's time to just allow yourself to rest is the message that I've been getting lately. So I'm trying really hard to do that, but it's really hard sometimes when you have so many things on your mind and on your plate and, you know, all this stuff you have to get finished. It's really difficult to just put it all aside and let yourself breathe, you know?
Oh, absolutely. I was just saying that to you before the show. I was like, you know, I've been having to let go of the readings for the rest of the year because I'm so busy that I have, like, this whole huge list of things I need to do, and I can't seem to mark not one thing off because I you know, and I was like, okay, everybody, that's it. And for you that don't know what I'm talking about, I'm no longer doing readings this year after May 31st. I'm just doing it for private clientele, and I did run a sale. You can find that on my Facebook page at Psychic Tea, But, you know, there's so much on my schedule that I literally had to sit down, Sarah, and say, what can I let go of? Because I can't do it all. You know, I spread so thin, I couldn't do anything else. It was like, oh, my goodness, what can I just not, you know, because, ooh. And like me and you discussed, you know, the mentoring and the classes, that's just more important to me, you know.
Yeah. Well, and good for you. I mean, sometimes we all need a lesson in that. I feel like we keep adding things to our plates over and over and over again. And a lot of us are really fearful to release or really hesitant to release, either because we're used to something or because we're afraid to let it go or because we really like it. But then, you know, there's always this idea, this societal norm of growth, growth, growth. You got to keep building and do more and be more and all of this. And you know, sometimes that's really, really unhealthy for society. So good for you to be able to release. And I need to do that too. So nice little reminder, right?
Yeah, definitely. You know, we all just want to kind of do everything, but in reality, we just can't. So, yeah, you just kind of got to look at what you got going on in your life and decide what you need and what you don't and what you can live with and what you can't, and just kind of put what you have to do first and what you'd like to do next and just kind of go from there. Otherwise, you'll do what I'm always doing, which is burning out. And I don't like to do that because when I burn out, I am burned out. Sarah will tell you, I am burned out when I am burned out. You can't get nothing out of me. I'm done. I'm just done.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and it's, Yeah, and it's been like that lately. So, yeah, definitely. So, and I know you just got back from Canada, and we haven't even had a show to talk about that yet. So since it had to do with animals, I think we should discuss that first. Tell us about Canada.
Oh, my gosh. Well, it was, the energy up there is absolutely beautiful and crisp. Everything was so crisp, and the property that I was at has very, very special energy. There's a couple portals on it. There were horses and dogs and cats and hawks and eagles and just all kinds of beautiful nature all around. At one point it was sunny and 70 degrees, and then the next day it snowed. And so it was just, I was there for a week, and I felt like I experienced so much within that week. But one of the really, really powerful experiences I had while I was there was receiving a healing with the animals. And this is very specific that the woman who does it, Lucia, who also does animal communication, she literally will set up a massage table in a horse corral, and whatever horses are supposed to be there to work on you, they'll volunteer and step into the corral along with any dogs or cats or, you know, any other animals. And what happens is they each approach you separately, and they'll tug on your, you know, your clothes or your skin, or they'll come and like tap something or blow something, or, you know, they're just all over the place. And so as they're doing their healing on you, Lucia is kind of speaking animal. She's telling everyone what exactly they're doing and what's coming up for them. And it was so magical and so intense. What an intense healing for myself. So it was really, really beautiful. Thank you for asking, T.
Oh, yeah. I saw one of your pictures of, like, you laying on your table with the horse, and I'm like, what is she doing? That's like a horse run, girl. But I was like, I don't know what she's doing. Until you told me, I was like, oh, okay. I'm like, I'm thinking this horse is like creeping up on you and you're like meditating or something. But
yeah.
Really cool.
Yeah, I'll post some pictures on my Journey in the Ether page for you guys. I haven't really posted many yet. But it's so cool. Even the type of healing is body talk, and it's a modality, and it works with the body and muscle testing the body. And within body talk, after you've completed a level of healing or a cycle, or after you've tweaked something or removed something, you do what's called tapping it out, where you tap on the crown and on the heart to remove the old memory, to lock in new memory, and then to lock it into the heart as well, that healing has just taken place. And it was so hilarious to you because the horses had just finished something, and Lucia came to tap on me, to tap me out. And one of the horses pretty much like knocked her aside, and it turned around and it took its tail and it went whip, whip, whip with its tail, and it tapped me with its tail, and it did it the entire time. But it was just so hilarious, and Lucia was like, oh, yeah, you're tapping, sorry.
Oh, wow. It sounds amazing. I don't do a lot of nature stuff. I mean, who doesn't know that about me, right? But I don't do a lot of nature stuff because I really don't connect to nature unless it's like water or something like that. But the closest animals I get to are, my daughter has two rabbits and I have two dogs, and then that's it. You know, but it's crazy because I actually grew up in the country where there were a ton of animals that I was always very drawn. But now I just don't have the opportunity. But now I just don't feel the need to do it. But I think it's so cool when other people can do it. Does that make sense? That's crazy.
Yeah. Well, and I mean, they're just so pure, and they're literally connected so easily to Source, and they have so much divine information within them that it's really incredible. You know, it's like being around a child or a baby, you know, that level of purity that they share. So it's really special, definitely. And when you get out into the wild, wild animals, they're even more intense. Like the elephants were absolutely incredible. It was beautiful.
See, I love elephants. That is one reason I cannot go to the circus, everybody. Every year, my adopted mother buys circus tickets for the kids, and I refuse to go because could you imagine me at the circus? I'd be running around screaming with some bolt cutters going, I'll free you all. It's going to be okay. You know, I can't do it. I can't go to the zoo either. I will freak out if you take me to the zoo. It's like I will turn into a rebel and try to rescue everybody. It's crazy. So I just try to stay away from those places because there's really nothing I myself can do about it. But, you know, I am. It's very hard. I'm very sensitive when it comes to animals. And I think it's because I like can pick up on what they're feeling and thinking. So it's very hard. Isn't that weird? Anybody else would be like, oh, you could be like a pet psychic and talk to them. But I couldn't be one because I'm so sensitive. I will literally cry the whole, you know, I know, it's messed up. I know. And I'll get like nothing accomplished. So I don't even go that route, which is weird because I can do it. But it's just, it doesn't work for me. I'm too sensitive to it. It's weird. Isn't that weird?
Yeah, in a way. I mean, I totally understand with zoos, and, you know, the energy at zoos is normally horrible. Like, the only thing that lifts the energy up at zoos is all the kids being like, oh, look at the monkey and things like that. But, you know, if you take the children out of a zoo and you just have the animals there, a lot of them are so unhappy that it's awful. It's really awful. And I've never been to a circus. I never plan on going to a circus. But, you know, same thing. Those poor animals, I would highly recommend to everyone, there's sanctuaries all over the place. Find a sanctuary near you and really support that as opposed to the circus or the zoo, because they really know how to take care of wild animals at sanctuaries.
Absolutely. Yeah. You know, and remember what we do, our children imitate. So when you take them somewhere like a zoo or a circus, then you make them believe that that's fun and that's okay. Then the cycle repeats itself and just continues, you know. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. So absolutely find a sanctuary. Okay, we better get started, girl. We're just talking away.
I know. We're talking away.
Okay, well, today we're talking about wolf, hawk, and bear. Wolf happens to be one of my favorite ones. I think it's a lot of people's favorite. What do you feel about wolf, Sarah?
Well, wolf is one of my main guides. One of the first guide to ever approach me. So I think that the wolf is powerful, it's dynamic. You know, a lot of people have opinions about wolves, negative opinions, but in all reality, what they represent is the deepest level of you and your inner knowing, your intuition. They're so intelligent and social, and they really understand hierarchy. And so I just think wolves are incredible animals. Definitely. What about you, T?
Well, you know, anybody that's listened to my animal totem show that I did with Jeannie long time ago where I talked about my 7 animal spirit chakras, my heart chakra is a wolf. And that absolutely makes sense to me because when I think of wolf, I think of the mother, the leader, all the little wolf cubs running around that everybody needs to take care of, you know, and it being in my heart chakra makes sense, you know, because I have kids and I'm a very nurturing person. But I find it so wonderful that wolves will pick up abandoned baby cub wolves. A lot of animals won't do that. I know, I like elephants and things too, but you would think most people, they think of wolves, they're like, oh, you know, like in the, like in Twilight, and they're going to attack, and, you know, and they're vicious, and you go camping, you think, oh, I hear the wolves howling, I hope they don't come to the campsite. And most people have that fear about wolves, but, you know, they're very nurturing animals, and, you know, they'll pick up abandoned cubs, you know, they'll take care of, you know, that in the forest. They really take care of nature, and so you got to look at them in their own habitat, and you got to think, well, I guess if somebody, you know, put up a tent in my backyard, I'd probably go out there with a gun and act crazy too. So, you know, you can't really be mad for the stuff that they do in their own wild nature place. But I like the wolf as a nurturing type animal. A lot of people think of them as, you know, violent or attacking, and I look at it more as a motherly, nurturing type animal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely, and very sincere. It's like if you've ever been around a real wolf or a wolf hybrid, there is a rescue near me that rescues wolf hybrids and really homes them to people who can handle, you know, having a wild animal as a pet. And you literally, they see right through you. They see through everything. They see through your thoughts. They see through your fears. You have to be so sincere and open heart and just neutral when you're around wolf, because it's like they take away all of the layers of you that are no longer necessary. And so they're really special in that regard, that they have that power, you know?
You know, I'm glad you said that, because when I'm having trouble trying to decide what I want to do with my life or with a situation, I will call upon one of my animal spirits to try to help me. And the one that I did call upon when I was trying to decide what to do with the readings and the classes and what I wanted to keep and what I wanted to get rid of was the wolf. You know, I brought him next to me, mm-hmm. and I was like, you know, help me try to sort this out. And so I do believe they're very strong in that way. Like you said, you know, kind of what's no longer needed, helping you decide, you know, what's best for you, taking pride in you, you know, that mm-hmm. loyalty to your own self-preservation. And so, yeah, I love the wolf for that. And the message for wolf today, people, is the time is right to take risk. Face your inner fears. And that's something that I've been doing lately, is facing things that I've been scared to do, projects that I've wanted to start but scared of how they might turn out. So let wolf remind us today to just go ahead and face those fears and take that first step.
Wonderful.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah.
Fiercely loyal.
I love that.
And still fun. You know, yeah. they're still very gregarious, and they, you know, jump around, and they really get their point across.
Absolutely. I love that, guardian. I love that. Okay. Now, the next one is hawk, and hawk is also another one of mine. I think hawk is like, nope, that's a raven. I have a raven for my throat chakra, so we'll just ignore that I said that, because I did not do that properly. Okay. But, so what do you think about hawks, Sarah?
Well, hawks come to me in real time, real life, all the time, and they are messengers for me. If I'm having a bad day, if I'm not sure I'm on the right path, if I'm needing to be knocked out of maybe my current, you know, thought patterns, or if I'm zoning, or if I'm not paying attention to what spirit says, believe it or not, there will be a hawk there that will make itself very well known, whether it swoops my car or, you know, lands on the road in front of my car while I'm driving and I kind of have to slam on my brakes. They are so intuitive, and they really, it's almost like that eagle eye. I know we're talking about hawks, but it's the same thing, where they're able to see an entire span of all that is, and really hone in on what's necessary, what's not necessary, give you clear guidance, allow you to have the clear sight and the courage to move forward in what you're doing. So I really see the hawk as more of an illumination guide. What about you, T?
Oh, absolutely. You know, again, it was me, you know, trying to talk about, you know, what do I want to do? You know, what decisions can I make? And people feel so lost on their path a lot of times. And what they don't understand is there's these guides around to help them. And one of them, again, is the hawk on the hawk. And you can ask them to take a look at your life and try to put you in the right direction, you know. And sometimes I get crows, and I know we're not talking about crows. Like you said, we're not talking about the eagle. But I get a crow that will warn me of things to come. If something bad's getting ready to happen, I'll have a whole bunch of crows around me or around my house. It's the weirdest thing. But hawks, to me, represent like that higher consciousness, that helping you get to that next level, helping you with those decisions of what step to take next type of thing. So, you know, a lot of people are like, well, how do I know I got animal guides? How do I know who I could talk to? How do I know which ones are my own? Well, and of course, for that, you'll have to reach out to, you know, people for readings or stuff like that. But what I like to tell people is I did it kind of on my own. I just closed my eyes in meditation and asked them to present themselves to me. Don't do it in a bathtub like I did. I almost drowned. I talked about that. Also, in my show, do not meditate and ask for spirit animal guides in a bathtub. Don't do it. So, but yeah, you can just close your eyes and go into meditation and ask them to present themselves to you. And it's really just as easy as that. And if you're having a lot of trouble with that, you can reach out to me. You can reach out to Sarah, you know, and get a reading for that. Probably Sarah, because, you know, mine ends soon. So reach out to Sarah. JourneyInTheEther.com.
Yeah.
Reach out to Sarah. And she can help you find that and figure that out for yourself. So, yeah. So, okay, so Hawk's message for us is stay alert and aware. The signs you are seeking are very clear at this moment. And that makes a lot of sense because a lot of times the answers to our questions are right in front of us. But because we're expecting them to present themselves to us in a certain way, we most of the time miss them. So just stay alert and pay attention to everything that happens around you instead of looking for specific things. So, okay. So now the next one is actually one of mine. I knew two of them were, and this is actually my solar plexus chakra animal, which is the bear. And I do happen to like bear a lot. What do you feel about bears, Sarah?
Bears to me they're strong, they're beautiful, they're the almost like the spirit keepers. They change with the seasons, you know, their personalities and their level of activity changes with the seasons, and they're all about really going within and digesting the experiences that you're having and really taking that wisdom that you've been receiving and slowing down and letting it integrate within you. That's how I see bears. What about you, T?
Well, bear happens to be associated with my solar plexus chakra, which is also my creative and my power chakra. So I use bear to actually help me manifest all my projects. And so sometimes I procrastinate. Sarah's like, really? But sometimes I procrastinate. And I don't do things that I'm supposed to do or in a timely manner. So I sometimes I do feel lost, and I will call upon Bear to say, hey, you know, help me manifest this project. And, you know, and I take that strength and that confidence and that patience that the bear holds, and I use that to help me get through that project or at least see it till the end. And so that's why I like bear. You know, it really helps you push forward. You know, bears are very nurturing, and they're very confident, and, you know, they're very protecting. So when you feel like you're struggling, you can call upon that bear to help you get through it till the end, and it will give you those nurturing, healing type qualities. You know, it could, you could call upon Bear if you're upset or sad or depressed, or, you know, me, I grew up without parents, so sometimes I just need to feel love just for a minute, you know, so I can call upon that nurturing Bear to help me, you know, feel that nurturing just for that time that I need it, because we can't all just walk out the front door and hug a stranger, you know. We probably could, but I wouldn't guess it. You know.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I like Bears a lot. And the message from Bear is be clear about where your boundaries are and stand your ground. And I think a lot of people tend to, like, fall into line with what everybody else is expecting of them, or trying to live up to the perspective that other people think that they should. And it really is about figuring out who you are and trying to live your purpose and walk your path, no matter who it pisses off, you know. And I find that that's happening a lot, people coming into their own. What do you think, Sarah?
Agreed. Definitely that inner knowledge and strength, and it's almost that primal, you know. Bears have a lot of that really primal energy that they just do. They go with their instincts. There's not a lot of thought around it. You know, they see something dangerous, they immediately, you know, bare their teeth and growl and stand up on their 2 feet. Or if they see, you know, something that they want to hunt and eat, it's not necessarily one of those where they take a ton of time hunting it like a big cat would. They just freaking go for it. And what a wonderful message, you know, when Bear does show up in your meditations, which that's the best way I like to meditate, is just leaving it wide open and not having, you know, an idea of what will come forward, and then asking, you know, what type of animal medicine do I need today? What kind of messages are there from animals? And so when Bear shows up, it's telling me to be instinctual and go with my gut and really just get down to, like, those primal human behaviors of, you know, I've got decisions in front of me. What's the best for my survival? What's the best for my happiness? And go from there. So totally agree with you.
Absolutely, absolutely. And everybody, just a little quick reminder, me and Sarah do these shows. We try to do weekly or biweekly, and we'll have your next three animals on our next show. And if you have any suggestions of what animals you would like us to cover, you can check us out on Facebook and send us a quick little message. Mine is Facebook, of course, Psychic T, and Sarah's is Journey into Ether on Facebook. And, of course, my website is PsychicT.com. Now that's PsychicTEE.com, and Sarah's is JourneyIntoEther.com. And we got a lot of great shows coming up for you this month, next month, and every month after that, because me and Sarah just love doing shows and helping everybody out. And of course, I'll turn this into a video and place it on YouTube for you later. Okay, Sarah, is there any advice you'd like to give our listeners today?
I would say, just really be open to whatever type of animal is coming in, even if it's something random like a skunk or a spider or an otter or, you know, a sheep. They all have very, very deep meanings to them, and they all are very, very special, and they can help you in your current situation. So really be aware of what's showing up around you, what's in your dreams, what's in your meditations, and how you're reacting to that and how you're taking that medicine in as well, because there are big messages being sent, and it's all about being open to receive.
Absolutely. I love that, you know, and, you know, whatever animal you seem to be drawn to, like, I've always been drawn to the owl, and then ended up being my chakra animal. You know, I always say whatever animal you just always seem drawn to, but you don't know why, or that you just love and don't know why, but that's probably on Spirit Animal Guide. So try working with that one first and see if it resonates with you. And then once you get the feel for it, you know, you can try bringing in other animals. Just a thought. Okay, well, thank you, everybody, for tuning in tonight. And check out my Facebook page, Psychic T, to find out when my next show is. Thank you, everybody. Have a good night. Good night, Sarah.
Good night to you. Thank you so much, everyone.
We are calling.